Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the new video. In today's video, we are going to create an awesome looking cinematic title animation, which is super easy to create inside of DaVinci Resolve. You can also use this animation to create new year and Christmas presentation for this year. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 17 edit page, and before we get started we have to do some basic setting. So click on this setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. You can select 4K as well, and we have to select a frame rate. So in this case I am using this 30 frame per second. You can also select 60 frame per second for a smooth animation or 24 frame per second for cinematic. And after that you can click on save. And now we have to create this animation inside of this Fusion page. So we have to take a new Fusion composition. So just go to this media pool. If you don't have this media pool, then click on this media pool button. And after that, right click on this media pool and click on this new Fusion composition. And you can call it anything. So I'm gonna call it Fusion. Set the duration of this composition maybe 6 seconds long, which is good enough. Frame rate 30 and click on create. Now just drag this Fusion composition on this timeline just like this, and then go to your Fusion page, and here we have this media out node. So just drag this media out to the side for now, and now let's increase the size of this preview window. And for this animation we need only one viewer, so click on this single viewer. Alright, and now let's start by creating a background. So click on this background button and add a background node on this flow window. Drag this background to the preview window, and after that let's create a nice and simple gradient background. Select the background node, go to inspector window, and here we have to change the type and set it to four corner. And here we have four different color selection options for four different corner. So just go to the top left and select any color that you like. So I'm going to select this one. Just go to the bottom right corner and let's select the red color. And here we have some parameters. So let's adjust this value and create nice and simple gradient background. Just like this. And after that we have to create a text node. So this is the text tool. Click on this text button and add a text node. Drag this text to the viewer. Go to inspector window and type anything that you like. And after that we have to select a font style. So in this case I am using this Go Bold font style, which is my favorite font style, and of course you can select any font style that you like. And after that let's increase the size of this font. So I'm gonna set the value something around 0.22. let's down the line spacing value. So let's set the line spacing just like this. Set the line spacing value 0.85, and after that let's align the text in the center. So just go to this preview window, right click on that, go to guide and turn on this show guide option. Now we have to set the text in the center just like this. Alright, and after that click on fit button and just go to this transform tab, and inside of this transform here we have the sear. So let's open the sear and let's set the X sear and set the value something around -0.25, and it is looking like this as you can see. After that we have to merge this text with the background. So what we have to do, we have to take a new merge node, and inside of this merge node we will get four different points. So the yellow point is for background, green is for foreground, and this is the output. So I'm going to connect this yellow background point with this background, green foreground point with the text, and let's drag this merge one to the viewer. Select this merge, go to inspector window, and let's change the apply mode. So let's set this blending mode soft light. After that let's set the blend value and set it to 0.5 maybe. After that we have to increase the size of this text. So select the text and add a transform node with this. Let's arrange it just like this. Select the transform one, hit F2, let's call it a scale. hit OK, select the scale, let's increase the size. So I'm going to set the size maybe 2, and it's looking like this. After that, we have to take one more merge node. So this is the merge button. Let's drag this merge on this flow window, and again connect this yellow point with this merge one, green point with this set text output, just like this. And then drag this merge to the viewer, and we will get something like this, but there is no animation on it, so we have to animate this text. So what we have to do, we have to take a new transform node just after this scale for the first output, which is looking like this. And we need to add one more animation node for this one, which is looking like this. All right, so select the scale, add a transform. Let's add one more transform node by dragging like this. And this is going to be animation 2. So hit F2, let's call it animation 02. And this is going to be the animation 01. So this is the first animation and this is the second animation. Now let's add this animation 2 just after this text 1 output. Hold shift on the keyboard and let's attach this animation 2 right over here, just like this. Now select this animation 1 and go to very first frame of this animation, right click on size, click on animate, select this animation 2, right click on size, click on animate, and go to the end of this animation, and this is the animation 2. So let's set the size value 0.8, which is 80%. Select the animation 1, and for this one we have to set the value 0.9, which is 90%. And now we will get this type of 3D looking zoom out animation. After that, we have to add one more effect just after this animation 2. Hold control and a space bar for search box and search for glow effect. So this is the glow effect. Hit add button. Make sure the glow is attached just like this. And after that, we have to do some setting with the glow. So select this glow and go to inspector window. Let's increase the glow size and set it to 25. Let's decrease the glow intensity and set it to 0.6. And now it's looking perfect. You can see before and after. And after that, we have to add some particles. Just right click on this flow window, go to add tool, go to particles, and here we have to select this P emitter. Hold control and a space bar for search box and search for P renderer. So this is the P renderer, which is particles renderer. Hit add button, and after that, select this P renderer, select this output mode 2D, and let's connect the P emitter with this P renderer, just like this. And after that, we have to attach this P renderer with this merge 2. So what we have to do, we have to take a new merge node, connect this yellow background point with this merge 2, green foreground point with this P renderer, drag this merge 3 to the viewer, select the P emitter, and let's do some setting and create nice and simple particles. So select the P emitter, let's increase the size of this emitter and set it like this. And then we have to do some setting inside of this inspector window. So select this P emitter, let's increase the random seed and set it to 50. Let's increase the number and set it to 50, or you can set the number 25. And we have to increase the lifespan, so I'm going to set it to 1000. After that, let's open the velocity and let's increase the velocity variance and set it to 0.01. And you can see the particle just like this. Now let's go to style, and here we have to change the style. So let's change this to blob. Open the size control. Let's increase the size and set it to 0.12. And let's increase the size variance and set it to 0.2. All right. And after that, we have to add one more effect. So just select the merge 3, hit control plus a space bar and search for CC. It means color corrector. Hit add button, drag this color corrector to the viewer, And after that, we have to animate the skin right over here. So just go to on frame number 15, which is equal to half a second according to 30 frames per second. And right click on gain, click on animate. Go to on frame number 165, which is 5.5 seconds. Right click on gain, click on set key, or you can also click on this diamond button. Just go to the end of this animation. Let's increase the gain value and set the value something around 4. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's increase the gain value and set it 4. And now we will get something like this. Go to the center of this animation, maybe on frame number 90. And let's increase the gain value and set it to 1.4. And go to 10 frame back in time on frame number 80. Let's set it to default. Go to 10 frame forward in time from frame number 90. So it should be frame number 100 and set it to default. And after that, we have to make it smoother. So just go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. Let's check this color corrector. Click on fit button. And we have to create easy ease keyframes, so select both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, set the CTI right over here, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create nice and simple smooth curve. You can hold this handle as well, set it like this and create seamless curve just like this, and do the same thing for this curve. So select these two control points, hit S to smooth, set the CTI right over here, hold this handle and just drag it like this. Hold this handle and set it like this and create seamless curve. Select these three keyframes and hit S to smooth. Alright, and then you can close the spline window and it's looking very nice. After that, you can connect the main output with the media out just like this, and then go to the edit page. And after that, I'm going to show you how you can create multiple slides. So select the fusion composition. It's very simple. Hit Ctrl C to copy. Place the CTI at the end of this. Hit Ctrl V to paste. And this is the second composition. Place the CTI right over here and go to the fusion page. And here we have to add a color corrector just after this background. And you can control the color by setting this hue value, as you can see. Alright, so you can select any color that you like and you can simply change the text. Just like this. Alright, and then go to the edit page. And here we have this nice and simple Merry Christmas and Happy New Year presentation, which is looking absolutely fantastic. So just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. Also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.